from below the gnat line. You'll be able to see that during this interview. Time to get the Taylor County perspective here in 2022. What's it like being the guy in charge?
It's been a new experience as somebody that I've always wanted to be a head coach, and like a lot of people out there, get lucky enough to have that opportunity. There's a lot of things that you like to do, and there's a lot of trial and error in it. And luckily here at Taylor, I've got great administration and great assistant coaches that are helping put things in place, and we're really happy in the direction we're going.
All right, let's talk about the R word, and it can mean either reclassification or region. In this case, it means region, because there are some folks who gained A's, some folks who lost A's. Right now, single A is Division I and Division II. You slide a region over. When you look at the region this go-round and the split in single A, what do you see?
We don't pay a whole lot of attention to that, really. We know that our region is as tough as anybody from top to bottom. A lot of great, great athletic programs overall in this region, especially when it comes to football. Everybody's going to be competitive. Everybody works year-round to get better. We're trying to get in that fold, and we're trying to, make sure that we're doing everything we can do to be competitive in all our sports, and especially football.
When it comes to Middle Georgia, Central Georgia football, it is its own animal. I mean, right. You can be here on a Friday night. You can be in any town on a Friday, given Friday night. You really get to see what it means. From your time here, what have you been able to discern about what it means here to Taylor County?
I think what it means to Taylor County right now is that we want to try to make all athletes and all athletics a greater priority, and do whatever we can to move everything forward, not just from a football perspective, but all of our athletics and in the building, all of our clubs and everything. We're trying to take the next step and just improve overall. Football specifically, we've had really good success so far with involvement and participation from a parent and a student athlete perspective, and from a staff and administrative perspective as well. We've had a really great outpouring of support, and there's a lot of really good energy and positivity right now surrounding us, and all we're going to try to do is just keep working every day to improve and build on it.
Last question for you, and it has to do with our Recruiting 2022 show. At the end of the show, every week, we have a segment where Matt Stewart and I talked about make that kid an offer. Mm-hmm. And it's around the state, and for whatever reason, there's a student athlete that's overlooked. He's too short, in quotation marks. He doesn't have enough weight on him for whatever reason. Right. Or, geography has kind of created a difficulty to try to recruit an athlete.
Right.
Is there someone here that fits that bill where you'd sit there and raise your hand and go, make that kid an offer?
The name that comes to my mind would be Draquez Woodard. He's our starting running back. He's a senior. He's put together some solid years up to this point in terms of his numbers. We expect his numbers to be better this year. He's a great kid, a great leader off the field, in the weight room, does what he's asked, does what he's supposed to do in the classroom, makes good grades. I think his future is bright regardless, but I definitely believe that a solid year this year could increase its value at the next level.
And we'll keep an eye on things here at Taylor County in 2022. That's your outlook.